Hi guys, so I just want to share with you a quick recipe for a pumpkin curry. If you're on low sugar or doing shape up and you're not allowed to have tomatoes, you can do this recipe and leave out the tomatoes. So the first thing I have here is some cut up green sweet peppers. Then I've got a bunch of pumpkin that's chopped up. I would say it's about a cup and a half of chopped up pumpkin, about 3/4 of a medium green sweet pepper. I've got one small onion. I've got about 4 kale leaves. It's not really a lot. Bajan kale. And one small tomato. To this, I'm going to add some curry paste. I made this myself. Can't see how yellow it is in the camera. I'm not sure why it looks kind of brown in the camera. But it is a brownish sort of color because of turmeric, but the inside of it is really, really yellow. And it's just made with equal parts of turmeric. It's got some ginger in there and the same amount of garlic as well. So equal parts of turmeric, ginger, and garlic. As you can see, it was a jar full, but there's hardly any. But I'm going to use 2 tablespoons of this. And I'm going to make a vegan dish. The cool thing about this dish is that you can use it as an accompaniment. This morning I'm using it as an accompaniment for eggs. People don't eat eggs. As I said, this is a vegan dish, but it's a real good way to get some healthy carbs, to get some vegetables. You can eat it any time of the day, and it's just a way better way to get carbs than to put 2 pieces of bread next to your breakfast. So when you have that extra 10 minutes, because that's all it will take, an extra 10 minutes, try this recipe. It's very simple. I'll show you when I get to the stove. Okay, please, I've warmed my skin. Can't stop milk, I've already started. Alright, so I've got some jewer or ground cumin along with some red curry paste I told you guys about. And I have to put in the rest of the ingredients. Okay, so I've put in everything. And that's why it's such a simple recipe. This is not no fry the onions first and do all of this and do all of that recipe. This is a real simple low recipe here. So we're just going to make sure that that everything is stirred together nicely. That way the seasoning will be evenly distributed. We know the gas bottle that has to get put in the cupboard. Oh, sorry, talking to you all. No, man, he's joking, man. You can say hi back. Alright, so we're just going to make sure everything is well incorporated. Then I'm going to put a little bit of water in here. This water from the kettle, so it's already hot. This is enough water to basically cover the bottom, and we're just going to simmer that until the pumpkin is cooked. Then we're going to taste it for salt and pepper, and it will be finished. So just give it about 5 minutes because the pumpkin's cut nice and small, and I'll show you the end product. Okay, so this has been going for 6 minutes and it looks about finished. I just was letting some of the water come out of it because I want it for breakfast. If you look at it, you can see the consistency. Has a little bit of liquid in there. If you were going to be serving this with rice and eating it as a meal, I would say that it's definitely finished. But for my purposes, because I want to have it with breakfast, and my breakfast is eggs, protein, other than this, I'm going to let it come down just a little bit more. What I like to do is just spread it out and let the liquid stay in the middle so I can see how much liquid there is. You can see it's not much. I'm just going to let it thicken up about 1 or 2 more minutes, and then I'm going to turn it off and let you guys see everything at the end. I tasted it for salt, and it's good. I added maybe a large pinch of salt. Okay, so here you have it. It's all finished. It looks really yummy. And I'm serving it with my fluffy scrambled eggs over here. As I said, this can go over rice. It can go with potatoes. It can go with sweet potato. You can add sweet potato to the actual mixture and make a warm pot. You can add chicken to this or fish. This is just a very versatile little way of doing pumpkin. And I think it's important to understand that pumpkin is not just, you shouldn't just view it as a vegetable. But it's a very viable carbohydrate source with a lot of B vitamins and other good stuff. And sometimes, you know, we don't make the most of vegetables. Also, there's a great way to get kids to eat kale. It's broken down a lot so their teeth can handle it. It's just a really good way to get some good nutrients in early or late in the day, whenever. And the cool thing about it, you could always make it in advance. And then once you've made it already, you have it in the fridge when you do your meal prep and stuff, you just make a lot. So you have it in the fridge already. So then, you know, on the days when you don't have that extra 10-15 minutes in the morning to chop up vegetables, you can still have it, you know, next. Just warm it up in the pot when you make your eggs, or warm it up in a pot or in the microwave, and you're good to go. All right, thank you for watching. Bye.